So easy, tell me, how is your life as a youngster?
Ruthless, my style is a juvenile, ran with a gang, slanged in the meanwhile, banking. I specialize in ganking, white, Mexican brothers and others, daily. It's all about coming up, making sure no punks are running up. You go, you know who I am, and if you don't like it, I really don't give a damn.
La 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 la. Focus. Beauty, pop in, let's go. So you're probably wondering why I'm dressed all... And no, it's not because I wanted to look like I didn't just roll out of bed for once. Well, actually, that is the case, partly. But also because in today's video, I'll be giving you some top tips and tricks on how to throw a killer house party. Or a fat sesh, like me and my pals? Like me and my friends like to call it. Is sesh like a word? Do lots of people call it a sesh? Is it national? Like, is sesh a used word? I even did my makeup. I'm out of focus, but look. Also, I took the risk of asking my friends to send me some tips and tricks on how they think you should throw a house party. So stay tuned for that. Oh my god. So without further ado, let's crack on with the video. Little disclaimer, I did go off the rails. So I wouldn't take my tips and tricks straight to your chest.
So we're sat on the floor now. I've got my list.
Frizzy hair track. So my first tip to throw a killer house party, or a sesh, is to pay attention to when you invite the people. The people? The guests. The friends, the folks of your local town. Think logically. Don't go and invite in everyone you ever know. I made that mistake once. Invite as many people you think your house can hold. And when inviting your guests, mention dress code. You don't want people coming in their ball gowns and then someone coming in their tracksuit. Quick little story about my house parties. The girls always used to dress up lush, literally spent hours getting ready, and the boys would rock up in their tracksuit and hoodies, and no one would make the effort except for one or two. To be honest, I would love a guy to rock up in a suit. I mean, that's a bit overdressed, but who doesn't love a guy in a suit? Also, when inviting, do possibly mention bring your own bottle, because it's hell of a lot easier than providing a bunch of drinks for everyone, especially because everyone's got different tastes as well.
My knees hurt. I'm sitting on my knees.
So to my second tip to throwing an amazing sesh. Why do I talk like Buddy King Julian?
Maurice, you cannot run around like a footless chicken.
So yeah, my second tip. To get an awesome music playlist. Music that appeals to everyone, not just yourself. This song always made the crowd go wild.
Sorry, Miss Jackson, I am for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry.
Try and aim for music that's quite dancey, but do have some chill bops in there, even though dancing is the best part of a party, as well as making out with someone. And don't forget the bad decisions I used to make. Speaking of which, if you're struggling to come up with a music playlist for your house party, I have a killer one on my Spotify, so feel free to check it out. I do not want to toot my own hoot, but everyone did love my music. When I say everyone, I mean about 50%. I mean about 25%. I'm joking, they all loved it. So my third tip to throwing a good house party, set out different areas. Let me explain. First off, make sure your guests know where the bathroom is. Just so if anyone needs to be sick, they can just run to the bathroom. Because you don't want them throwing up all over your sofa. That did happen. I had to clean that up. Do I name drop? Fuck it. Thank you, Jonah. God. Speaking of throwing up, bonus tip. Have buckets, bowls, or bins or whatever close by just in case. Aim for places for mainly dancing and then areas for chatting or snogging. Do people say snogging anymore? Or am I just stuck in 2007? Places for bags and coats and as well places for snacks and drinks. Speaking of snacks and drinks, that brings me on to my fourth tip to throw a good house party. Provide little cheap snacks, so like crisps or chips if you're from America. It's little things you can, like, you know, Because sometimes people are hungry and it keeps people from getting too drunk. If you do provide drinks, and don't say bring your own bottle, provide the cheap stuff, try and get a variety of stuff as well. But don't go all out unless you're rich, in which case please invite me to your next party. And that brings me on to my fifth tip. Prepare some party games. You may not need them, but just in case the party starts to die down, it's always good to have something on hand to play so people don't get bored. Otherwise, you'll be known as the girl or the boy with the dead party. My go-to one was Truth or Dare. Oh, that was a fun one. However, there's always Never Have I Ever, Beer Pong, classic, Kiss and Blow, etc. There's loads of stuff online you can look for. In worst cases, chuck on the cha-cha slide or the Macarena or Mr. Brightside. That always pumps up the party. Enough, moving forward. Okay, my sixth and final tip. Why do I look so weird? That's not my tip. My sixth and final tip, control. I know, kind of a boring one, but it's a vital one as well. Very hypocritical of me to say, but try and be the most sober there so you can keep things in hand. And don't be afraid to say no as well. Like if there's more people coming, or someone's trying to smoke in your kitchen, that happens, say no, or get your scary friend to say no like I did. But do be prepared to say no. Don't be a pussy. Bonus tip, yeah, don't be a pussy. Also, be prepared to clean and tidy. Seriously, it is going to probably be a massive mess. And don't be afraid to ask for help as well. Like, they came and had fun, they should at least try and help tidy up. A bonus tip, keep kitchen roll at hand in case somebody just spills a drink or explodes. And if someone throws up, little story actually, at one of my house parties, this guy just threw up all over my hallway and I literally had to run to get kitchen roll. Did I clean it up nicely? No. I did like a water slide in it with kitchen roll, not just doing it for fun. Not on purpose either, that sounds weird. I was quite drunk at the time. I didn't voluntarily just do a water slide in somebody's puke. That's just strange. Anyway, that's the end of my tips on how to throw a good sesh or house party. And now for the list of tips and tricks my friends sent me. Gosh. Oh no. So the first off, they suggested their favourite drinks. So we have first have dark fruits. To be honest, a banging drink, not gonna lie, lived off that shit last year. And then thank you, Joe, for suggesting 2 for £5 hooch from Tesco. Oh, and good old cheap vodka from Tesco too. Gotta love Tesco. Just to clarify, this video is not sponsored by Tesco. Another tip for my friends was to have a roof. If you watched my off the rails video, you know that at one of the parties, some lads actually did climb my roof.
Bonkers. You're gonna die.
Yeah. Got into severe trouble about it. Thank you, boys. Send you my love. Ew. We also have a good tip from one of the lads. Bus sign theft makes a good sesh an excellent one. Thank you, Barzy. At one of the parties, he did indeed steal a bus sign.
Barzy just stole.
Yeah, boy!
A bus sign!
Criminal life!
Very legendary, to be fair. Quite illegal, I think. Did he get in trouble? I don't know. Does he still have the bus sign? I don't know. What a mad lad. Another tip, a supportive neighbour to call the old bill if it all gets out of hand. Thank you, James. So yeah, keep your neighbours on standby, but keep them on your side. And hopefully they don't call the police like mine threatened to many times. Which is understandable, the boys were on the bloody roof! Oh, a lovely one, have a designated top shagger bedroom. Yummy. I mean, to be fair, when you're making out with someone, you don't want to be doing it right in everyone's eye line, because that's just awkward. Especially if they end up not being a good kisser. You're like trying to swerve them away in front of everyone. Just makes it awkward for everybody, doesn't it? A lovely tip from Joe again. Have a bath to cry in. To be fair, having a bath to cry in at a party is very therapeutic. And if you're dirty, you can just have a wash at the same time. Multitasking, having a mental breakdown, and doing some self-care. Kr. Ooh, I can roll my R's. Oh, I lost it. I'm just so cool, you know. Oh, I actually really like this tip, to be honest, from Joe again. A place to hide your alcohol. Very good tip, to be honest with you. For instance, at one of the parties, me and Joe collaborated and he put my vodka bottle on top of my wardrobe so no one could get it, except for him because he was the tallest. To be honest, I think that was a way of him stopping me from drinking more. Yeah, quite possibly. Quite another good one that you should probably actually take seriously. This normally applies if you're going to a house party, but keep someone more sober than you to sort of manage and make sure you're okay. Otherwise, if everyone's completely wrecked, you're probably gonna get run over by a car or something. Especially if you're one of the boys who at my party were skateboarding down the middle of the road.
Go! What a mad lad.
Didn't die. This is my favourite one. A little sister to snake on you to your dad. Yeah, so a lot of the reason why my dad found out about how bad those parties got was through my little sister. Love you, Kaylin. I forgive her now though, but damn, she can talk. Sibling snake, what can you say? Oh, another important one, don't have any axes on hand. Or any weapon for that matter. So I had this axe at my garden, some of the lads found it, and as you do, you bring it in and start whopping it about. Who doesn't see a weapon and want to immediately look very threatening with it? Thank you boys, again. Also shout out to the one who axed my stole. That was my dad's last straw. He flipped. He proper flipped over the stole. I don't know why the stole though. You would think that the roof got to him more. But the stall. Another tip from one of my mates? Have some twins to run after you with knives. Cause it always spices up a party. If you couldn't guess, we had twins at my party that would run around with knives. To be fair, I don't actually remember that. But I do remember the knives being hidden a lot in case they got ahead of themselves. They wouldn't actually aim to kill anyone. I don't think. Good tip as well, a nearby park to pre-sesh. You can't really control this one, but it's always a bonus to have a park. Especially if they annoy you, you just kick them to the park. That's what I did. To be honest, they really did annoy me. One time I got so annoyed at a party, I literally just put my pajamas on and went to bed while the party was still going on. I let you in my home. I let you drink. Why you annoy me? Why? Oh, I'm stretching. Oh, ow. And my last tip for my friends, have tea. That's such a British tip. Have tea on hand. To be honest, tea is a great way to sober up at the end of the night. There is not one situation you can't solve with a good old cup of tea. And when I'm drunk, personally, all I do is crave tea. Speaking of which, coffee is also a good one too to sober up. But if you're trying to settle down, have a cup of tea. Make it all milky, put some sugar. So that's it from my friends' tips and tricks. So that leads me to the end of the video now. I hope you enjoyed mine as well as my lovely friends. Lovely. I mean, they did get me kicked out of the house, but it's fine. All forgiven. No negative energy here. Currently we are in lockdown, so you can't technically have house parties at the minute. But when this all blows over, just remember my tips and tricks and you can have the best party or sesh ever. But do not make the same mistakes as I did, alright? Please don't. Otherwise you'll end up homeless. Or living with your nan. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, subscribe. Comment down below if you want more tips and tricks on other little things. Or more story times on my parties. But yeah, thanks again for watching. This is Crazy Girlie. And I'll see you in the next video. Wait, do I woe? Fuck it, let's be cringe, and I'm gonna whoa.